Inaugural supercard of the year. We've got one, two, three, four great title matches.
That we do.
And, of course, the 30-man Brawl for All over-the-top Battle Royal, where the winner will go on to Armageddon 6 to face the UWA Heavyweight Champion, who at the moment is Archadia.
Can we get the camera off that referee guy? He's making me sick.
Sean Damage McNelis here, walking through what used to be our locker room. Gotta say, it's giving me chills. Never ever thought I'd be UWA Heavyweight Champion standing right here. But ladies and gentlemen, let's take a look back at when I wasn't the UWA Elite Heavyweight Champion, but the UWA Regional Champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, the opening contest of Brawl for It All 2005 is set for one fall.
That's a little TMA, that's what I like.
Introducing first, from Corinth, New Jersey, here's Tara Valifax.
Quite the challenge ahead of her here.
Damage.
Used to competing in the cruiserweight division.
Damage is a very lucky man.
She has the man who claims to be the greatest regional champion of all time.
And now, introducing her opponent in this regional championship match. From Charlotte, New Jersey. Here is Sean Damage McNelis. Oh boy!
Man's got something to say.
Oh my goodness!
Can we get a working mic?
I'm sorry, there, pal.
Tara. How you been, sweetie? I missed you in the off season. How you doing? Okay.
She seems
alright. I understand that you're probably mad at me,
right here,
because of all the things that happened last year. But I'm here to make a mess.
Sir Teddy.
Make a mess.
I heard about what happened to your boyfriend. Okay, that's. And personally, I wanted to apologize. I wanted to let you know I'm sorry. And if he's having any problem performing his duties to you, you just let me know.
Oh! Ring that bell! Ring that bell, Bill!
Somebody threw the ring bell.
Oh my God. I swear, you are so in...
Oh, you got him. Damage is a man of the ladies. And
all right. This is.
Is he gonna just do it?
Oh! I didn't. Oh, ring that bell. Oh, she hit him with the Joker driver right off the back. One, two. Oh, he's out. A little too early for the Joker driver. Arkham's finisher. That is something else.
It's not gonna be that easy.
Damage versus Tara. Tara, Damage drops down. Tara up. Damage going for a huge sambo. Tara out of it. Oh, a big kick to the side of the head.
That's gonna hurt.
I can't see. This damn speaker's in my way.
I know. We gotta get it taken care of.
Damage off the rope. Tara with an arm drag.
Oh, by the way, our guest commentator today is Teddy Evans. No relation to you, John, whatsoever,
yes,
of course.
I love you all at home, but you sons of bitches want to beat me, but I'm watching the action right now. Oh, arm drag.
Oh, a big roaring elbow.
See,
you hit a
if
woman.
If I was damaged, I wouldn't be worried about bruises. I'd be ripping at the clothing. You know? I'd just take something off with an item or two. You
well,
know?
I wouldn't be
That's
shocked.
How we do it in Canada. Anyway.
Wouldn't be shocked if Damage cops a feel here.
Yes, I'm pretty sure he has already.
I can't lie. I wouldn't mind seeing that, but let's focus on the wrestling here.
One, two.
He just caught the feel right there?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he did.
Oh, a big leg drop. Oh.
And another elbow.
Yes.
Sorry about her face, Arkham.
Really? That was the back of her head.
One, two.
Oh, what a big kick out by Tara.
Big kick out by Tara.
That's shocking.
I didn't want to do this.
He's telling him now he did not want to do this.
Well, I'm sure Damage would have rather this man would have held over, you know, a candlelight dinner or something, but
that's always cool.
Damage has been so-called sweating Tara Valifax for the past year now.
Sweating? Sweating? What are you trying to say, huh?
The hot sports.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
A big spine buster!
I'm saying Damage hates her because he loves her. That's what I'm saying.
I think you're a player-hating son of a bitch.
This may be true.
It may be true. You need to take a trip up to Canada. We'll set you straight. Look at him. That's how you treat a woman. Look, picking her up off the ground.
Tara pushes him
off.
But
she doesn't want the help. Just like those Canadian sluts. That's why I don't bone all the skanks. Deranged banged my girlfriend.
Oh, what a big clothesline right
there. That's why I sent them packing from Canada. That's why he had to steal some gas and he went to jail.
Damage had a strength advantage here.
Oh, big overhead.
Belly. Wow. Absolutely wrecked Tara with that.
This is a no contest.
One, two.
Yeah, but she still keeps fighting. I mean, she kicks out.
It's been very obvious that Damage has been in firm control of this match from the get-go.
Well, no, the get-go we saw Tara hit the Joker Driver.
Yeah, that's whatever. Right.
Yes. Yes.
Sambo.
Sambo.
Sambo coming up.
Oh! Yeah, he caught it. In a very
cold. Oh, Tara just kicked Damage right in the back.
Damage just taking it to Tara right now.
Uh-oh, could be going for that worm elbow.
There he is. I think it is coming.
I think he's going for the moonsault.
Uh-oh, the Shawn Moon.
You're not Shawn Michaels.
Knees got up.
Oh, Damage. He's in a world of pain right now.
Tara Valifax working back to her feet right now.
I am dying for a stitch to pop in those shorts. Something to come out.
Oh, come on, Teddy Evans. Focus on the match. I know we're supposed to be professional.
Uh-oh, it could be the Pedifax.
Yeah, she hits it.
Damn the creator of those shorts that hold together so well.
And a big kick out. Fight Damage.
Damage now on the defense.
Oh, big forearm. Oh my God. The Ace Jack Killer.
What is this?
Oh my God. I think he threw him in his face.
Jesus Christ.
One, two. And he kicks out somehow!
It's gotta just be on instinct to Damage kicks out.
Like, give it to me harder, bitch.
Wow! I don't think he wants that.
No. I think he might.
He's and she clocks him again!
And she definitely gives
him the cobble eye! Damage pushes her off! Oh, but his shoulders! Oh, big Death Valley driver looks like.
More like a Death Valley neck breaker.
Yeah.
The back of Tara is about to be snapped into two.
That it might be.
Looks like it might be going for that Falcon Arrow. It calls the inferiority complex.
Every move that Damage hits affects the back area.
Got her up.
Big Falcon Arrow coming.
Oh, he nailed the inferiority complex.
Right on the back.
Thanks, I didn't know the name of that.
One, two.
That was it. Damage finishes Tara Valifax.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner and still UWA Regional Champion, Shawn Damage McNelis.
Damage, I think enjoying this position.
Well, we got a winner and still Regional Champion.
Yo, king of the south, and the kids checking for it. The number one question is how could you ignore it? And drop right back in the cut over basement tracks with raps that got you back in the sun. But in the meantime, there are those who want to talk this and that. So I suppose that against the wall, we feelings gotta get hurt and get dirty with the people spreading the dirty
And we're back!
Back we are.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest scheduled for one fall is for the UWA Cruiserweight Championship. Introducing first the challenger. This is Kris Kaos.
Come on, let's hear it! Come on!
There comes Kris Kaos.
Against definitely the most dominating cruiserweight champion in history.
That's right.
And here we go. Here comes the cruiserweight champion reigning of
He has been the cruiserweight champion for quite a while now.
And now, introducing his opponent from Lansing, Michigan. Here is the reigning and defending UWA cruiserweight champion, Kyle Winant.
He drops the smile, drops the hello, how you doing? And now he is an ass-kicking machine.
Yeah, he is. You're right about that. As soon as he's become a wrecking crew. Nobody is able to touch him.
Kyle Winant. That's what he's got.
Right.
Yeah, he has enough speed to keep up with someone like Kris Kaos.
Kyle Winant.
Super dexterity.
Oh, Kyle in the ropes. Ducks the line. Kyle up again. Ducks back elbow. Versus Kaos. Kaos in the rope. Kyle ducks the line. Ducks the elbow. A big beater attack! Shades of his older brother, Big Dan Winant.
And I guess I might have to agree with you now at this point with the power versus speed advantage.
Exactly.
That is a club.
You can only run circles around your opponent for so long until you get tired.
It's like getting hit with a mackerel.
What a kick! Huge leg lariat by Kyle Winant.
I can't see that
bro. I'm sorry.
See, now that's where Kyle Winant has the advantage. Kyle Winant, very young at his age, same skills as Big Dad, but more. Wait until he matures through this wrestling business.
I don't think he needs to mature. I think he's got what it takes right now.
He's got what it takes right now.
Push Kaos over.
Time, he'll just get
big super kick. Levels Kyle Winant. Kaos made his pulls up. We saw these two get into it in Vince Regal's office last week when Kyle Winant jumped Kris Kaos from behind.
Hit him with the belt.
Called him a little bitch. Here we go.
Kris Kaos trying to mount some offense here.
Big boot to the gut. The ample gut of Kyle Winant. Kaos.
To the face.
Oh, whoa!
Very nice.
That was impressive.
The dexterity, the agility.
That doesn't mean shit.
Spider-Man versus Juggernaut, you know?
No, I don't know.
Yeah, that's because you're not from my neck of the woods.
What neck of the woods would that be?
Across the trash.
Oh!
Huge kick to the back of Kyle Winant.
I'm pretty sure he will be paying out the rope, though.
He's got the ropes. That's the experience of Kris Kaos.
Kyle Winant mounts his comeback.
No, eventually, you know that.
I'm pretty sure of it. And here we go.
What a kick.
I've never seen anything like this. His shoulder. Big kick to the gut.
Murderous DDT.
A little too much running there, but Kyle leveled with Kaos.
He did it perfectly. He wanted to show that he has Kris Kaos just where he wants him. He could run circles around him if he wanted.
But you know, the endurance factor has got to be in Kris Kaos's favor. The longer this match goes, the more in favor of Kris Kaos it is.
I don't know.
Yeah, but at this point, I'm going to take him to a chop jump. Get a
I don't think so. With all the power moves that Kyle has.
He got a foot up.
Come on, Kyle, let's go.
That's a lot of beef falling
down. He's hung up on the ropes. Kris Kaos coming back in.
I don't like this Kris Kaos kid. He's too thin.
He's too thin. He's good for the cruiserweight division.
Exactly.
Mindless
sheep get behind this Kris Kaos guy. And here we go.
Kyle's
got his
number. Right on his head.
Kyle went for that. Showing that power always comes first. Your speed so long until it's taken from you.
Kaos went for that top rope Frankensteiner. Kyle caught him in the power bomb.
See, that's the thing with Kyle Winant owning the cruiserweight division. He can snap like that, a splash, and a big power bomb from the top rope. It's over. Virgin six. No,
he's got the power. You got it.
Whoa! Another super kick.
Saying that Kyle Winant
is smart for the second time. Fool me once, shame on me. Is that how it goes?
Fool me once.
And how was the third one? Well, attempt to fool and squash your ass. How about that? Let's go, Kyle. I believe that's
the Kyle. Come on, you son of a bitch! Come on, you son of a bitch!
Whoa.
Oh,
chaos. Go!
Oh, Kyle!
Go! Under!
The slugfest now, Bill.
Oh,
yes.
Big inside forearms.
Kyle Winant now proven that when you work on a man long enough, you take his speed away from him.
Get him, let's go!
Yeah, Bill, you said earlier Kyle Winant owns the cruiserweight division, and that is so true.
Come on, get him!
No one has even come close to dethroning Kyle Winant, but chaos made us do it.
Because there is no cruiserweight. There is no cruiserweight that can match the power of Kyle Winant.
That's right. I think you're right.
I know I'm right.
Big camel clutch coming here.
Oh!
Much like Techno, because he's going clubbing right
Virgin
now.
Virgin 2! What?
Oh!
And the referee needs to call this. Get in there, ref. Get in there. Ask him, does he give up? I'm pretty sure he said it 20 times already. One for each club.
Let's go!
Danny Baker, he doesn't kid around.
Standing 10 count. Count it, ref.
What?
Count him. One. He's out. Count it. Count it.
He's not going to count it.
Don't count it, Danny.
Come on. Count it. Count
one methodically taking.
He's still alive. I'm still alive.
Count one methodically taking his time here.
One.
What?
Yeah.
This is unusual. Oh.
Yes.
Oh, I guess he's okay.
No, really?
I just would have done
it. Let go! Let go!
Mr. Robot!
No! No! No!
Just one!
Two.
I think he's out.
Three.
It's a TKO. Kyle just TKO'd Kris Kaos with that hit to the face.
And that is why Kyle Winant is the UWA title. Because there is the power.
Paul Regal's
music.
Wait a second, what is he doing here?
What's he got in his bag?
I'm aware.
Maybe it's a slab of fat.
Kyle's getting rewarded with bacon?
You know, you did beat me last week. And you know, I felt the moonsault on my head.
Anyways.
And when you moonsaulted on my head, I did some thinking. And I'm here to prove...
No!
That is scale?
No.
That's a scale!
That's
a
scale! But you are well over the cruiserweight limit!
No, I'm not here!
I think you might have a point here, Bill!
Step on the scale, let's see if it's over 220.
Step up to me, what? Punk!
This will drop me about 10 pounds?
Oh my god, that scale!
We're looking at 270!
What?! What?! That's no cruiserweight!
May have taken
Take
off
your shoes
off, but you can kiss this jack goodbye.
Kyle just got silver cruiserweight title. Thanks to Paul Regal, official liaison to Punch Squad.
Before Jesus.
Ready for our tag team title match here as
there he is.
We've been met first
class.
Brian Brad.
Brian Brad. The first class. Now listen up, let's hear what
you're doing. UWA heavyweight champion Brian Brad has been on a losing streak as of late. Everybody I wrestle seems to beat me, and it's really pissing me off, because I've come to the conclusion, you don't beat me, you get lucky versus me. Eddie Idol got lucky. Ace Jack got lucky. Vincent Valentine got lucky. And most recently, Mike Quest got lucky.
They were flukes.
is it really pissing me off, because I noticed, you beat me once, that's your luck. You never beat me twice, because I'm good. You're never beating me a third time, because I'm great. So Mike Quest, come out here, because I got something to ask you.
We're calling out Mike Quest, the Eurasian champion.
But we wear pants and shirts in this league, all right? We don't come prancing around in underwear. My underwear has more than that.
Well, I got smaller junk.
Now, Crest, you beat me once. I'll give you credit for that once. But you got lucky. You're not beating me a second time. You're not beating me a third time. And to prove that, me and you, best of five.
You want to go best of five with Mike Quest?
Yes, sir.
No, I want to go best of five with Charlie Hawks.
Yeah. Best of five, me and you?
That's what I said.
I'll be a nice guy. We'll do best of five, and I'll throw my belt on the line.
Oh, that's huge. That is huge.
Because I know last week wasn't a fluke.
Yeah!
I'm like you, and I got fat on the off season. I've been working out and training hard.
We can tell by those speedos.
So you want to start a best of five?
Starting next week, me and you.
Next week?
Yeah.
You're on.
Watch yourself in
the Mike Quest! A best of five series between the Eurasian champion Mike Quest and first class Brian Brandt!
All right, this might sound a little biased, but I've chosen a good friend of mine for an interview today. And that superstar is Cypress. Now, in my personal opinion, you're the most successful superstar when it comes to UWA Brawl for All. So I gotta ask you, what are your thoughts going into 2005?
Well, you know, Arkham, buddy, I've been told, I've heard around the locker room that I have a target on my chest, that Vince Regal's put out a target, put a hit on me to throw me out, to make sure I don't win this thing. He's got Matt Mitchell, he's got Sky DeLeo, he's got Big Dan, he's got John Rome all after me. But you know what? You're right, Arkham. I've only been in two UWA Brawl for Alls, but you know what? I've won them both. I've never been thrown over that top rope in a Brawl for All yet. And it's, I'm going to be damned if it starts tonight. So if I got a target on me, I welcome all comers. Anyone, I don't care who you are, Big Dan, Scotty, Mitchell, Outlaw, H-Jack, Brass, I don't care. Bring it on. I've beaten them all before. I'll throw them all out. I'm begging you, rock the short shot. And after that, we'll be cheering. Let's hear it for Cypress.
Is that right, buddy? Mm-hmm. Is that right?
That's right, pal.
Rock the sure shot? We'll see, buddy. Because tonight, I'm in the Brawl for It All. And I'm taking my title back at Armageddon. You hear that, bub?
I'll see you out there.
And one more thing. Let's hear it for Big Dan.
I like your work.
You know, I'm quite fond of yours too, Dave. Good luck in the Brawl for It All tonight.
See you at Armageddon, jerky.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest scheduled for one fall is for the UWA Tag Team Championship. Making his way to the ring at this time, PC Blake Reynolds.
Has something to say.
It's funny. I try and move up in the tag team ladder, and then the liberals at the UWA knock me down.
Recession!
First, you know, they find a way to get rid of Collins, and then last year they found a way to get rid of Disaster. So I made a phone call, and let's just say Hedges is having a little problem with his visa.
What?
Wait a second.
So I talked to Mr. Regal, and this match gets to take place. I get my new tag team partner, Fire Liger. Like I said, it's fair.
It's not really fair.
We wrestle, you decide.
Lego!
Lego! Fire!
And now, introducing his opponent.
The lovable Joey Hedges, his partner, is currently not here.
Then Fire Liger still nursing a wrist injury after a freak accident when he's working out of the office of the lung care company.
Hey,
I'm not liable to talk about it. Come on.
Jim, we're ringing this
bell. Get one of them out of there.
Chet Jones, John Evans, can you explain to me where Joey Hedges is?
Well, apparently according
to Quake, Joey Hedges is not here.
He lost his visa. And I guarantee Quake got something
Liger
to do with it.
Liger loses visa before Hedges?
They're both foreign. And Eddie Idol set up.
Hedges, that
he go back to Mexico.
What is he
doing? Eddie Idol wants to do Hedges sumo rush. Oh, and he's doing
what
it.
What the hell?
Eddie Idol having a little fun at Fire Liger's expense here.
Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, uno.
Fire Liger holding his own.
Yeah, he is.
He should have. Fire Liger pounding away at Eddie Idol. He might try to keep Eddie Idol away from the corner, keep him in his own corner, and work Eddie Idol over and get the pin. Don't even let Quake in, because Quake's obviously a fresh man. That's how I would work it if I was Fire Liger, but I'm not. Oh, and a huge calf kick.
Huge calf kick.
Hello, everybody. I'm back from my brief.
Oh, hey, Bill.
Big suplex from Liger. Good afternoon. But that's inexperience. That's not the expense. The factor of not having a partner. Joey Hedges could have come in there and
Hedges' limo is just pulled up in the back.
Limo.
Hey, hey.
Hey.
Well, we're hearing rumors that Joey Hedges may be near.
I don't know. You lost your visa. I thought he'd get you that fast.
Yeah, exactly.
And now, that's what he didn't. That's what Liger did not want to do.
Tag now in the fresh man and Liger has no one to tag.
Oh! Quake attacking the knee of Fire Liger.
Oh. Of course, you got a broken arm. You're going to go out. No!
That makes sense, doesn't it? Hey, rope break. Come on.
Oh, goodness gracious. We don't know where Joey Hedges is. And fire! False alarm.
Somebody in the electronics room just lost their job.
In the truck
back there, yeah.
Production truck.
You got a production crew. Give it up for him.
Well, maybe he was trying to help Fire Liger out. Maybe I should lose his job.
No.
Willis!
completely and utterly shoeless! They cut the bottom!
The fans are pandemonium here! They've exploded for Joey Hedges!
Yeah! Come on! Keep out!
Come on!
Joey!
Come on!
Uh-oh. Here he goes.
Yeah!
Oh, the burning bush is alive and well. The tag team champions of the United Wrestling Alliance, Eddie Idol, goes to reverse Hedges.
And at least somebody's falling.
Oh, come out!
Come out! What a lie!
Let's go over Bulldog!
That was wonderful.
Heather! But Casey Reynolds getting it to break Reynolds, it up.
Darn. Bark knocker.
So.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Hedges is here. He's not the legal man, but he's here.
No, he's barefoot.
He's going Samoan.
Barefoot Hedges.
Oh, too bad you weren't in there.
Samoan now. Shoeless Joe Hedges. And Shoeless Joe Hedges gets in the ring.
Throws him off.
That's the line. Oh, and a big double side effect.
One, two,
Eddie Idol having some cantle issues here.
Brace the eyes of Judge.
He was in the middle of land today. Leave him alone.
Why would he even touch him?
Nunchuck.
What was that stupid? No! What are you doing?
Oh, God, if they bash someone into that, that's disgusting.
Rub his face in the sock.
Hit!
Oh, Hedges is coming up with that Tajiri rush.
Kill it!
Oh, he hit the bumper hard.
Quake in now.
Unforgiving ring.
Quake, huge knees of the gut of Joey Hedges.
And a snap there.
That's how you doing. Watch the trigger, buddy. Work in the back here. Hedges hit his back, hit the turnbuckle hard. This is going to be a very effective one. Quake laying him in to Joey Hedges.
Wait.
Hedges came in the house of fire, but that's it. Slowed down.
Absolutely all over Joey Hedges.
I gotta tell you, John, he's been very impressive early on this year.
Casey Reynolds?
Yeah, I mean, it is his first match, but of the year, but he's been very impressive thus far.
Your knees.
Oh,
what a move.
A stutter variation right on his arm.
One, two,
Fire Liger just dies out.
Liger just, wow, jumped at him in a tag made to Idol.
I wonder what that wristband is.
That hurt?
Just comb your hair.
Hedges, Oh, big belly to belly.
He just got franchised!
No, it's not!
I understand. It's your body, sir. He's fully educated.
I'll forgive you.
So then we have a girl to work over here.
Eddie, I have laying shots. Is he going for a powerbomb? Oh, for a pile driver. Needs help from...
Be right back, guys. I gotta go to the bathroom.
And they can't get him up.
Well, John Evans is not looking very kosher.
Oh, and he got it.
Get out of here! Get him out of here!
Roll them up and compete for the champions! Roll them back!
One, two,
come back again!
One Fire Liger getting in the ring now.
Oh, that's that loop!
Right into that stinky,
dirty,
filthy, trash bag, bottom-feeding sock.
Huge elbow from Fire Liger.
Hey, who am I talking with up here, Chet?
Yeah.
Oh, hi, Johnny.
What's up, Chet?
How are the kids?
Those socks
are so wrong. Why is he got them on his hand?
No.
Yeah!
You mean please.
Come on.
Bring them up in the ropes there.
Grab the champions here. Keep it all. Joey Hedges breaks everyone out. Quake Eddie Idol in the ring again. Danny Baker lost complete control of this match.
Danny Baker hasn't had control of it. And now Quake taking the dive. Now,
They nailed him with it. Get out of here. They got him.
Fire!
Ladies and gentlemen, we're your winners and still UWA Tag Team Champions, Burning Bush.
Come on!
What is going on? We're a music here. Microphone
set. Yeah. Six production guys got fired today. Firelight.
Get out of here! But you know what? We'll return with the heavyweight title match.
We will.
And we're back with the UWA Undisputed Heavyweight Title Match.
Is there a doctor in the house?
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, set for one fall, is for the UWA Undisputed Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first, the challenger, from the Clark Medical Facilities in Clark, New Jersey, here's Dr. John Doe.
Regional and hardcore champion of the UWA.
This is very true, Bill.
Yeah, it is. And here's the Bouncer Jumbo. Ready to take the title from the Cruiserweight.
Here we go. Here he comes.
And now, introducing his opponent. From Brawl, North Carolina, he is the reigning and defending UWA Undisputed Heavyweight Champion.
Oh, what's happening?
The CD's.
There we go, we got production.
Here's Archadia.
Yeah. Unconceivable, unbelievable.
I don't need to. If these are the...
I'll fix it for
come
you!
Come on! Oh, it's the damn thing!
Alright!
And here we go!
Back from the bathroom, oh god!
Look who's there! Oh great!
Get out of here!
Look what the cat puked up!
Are
you kidding me?
We've got Archadia and Dr. John Bose. Dr. John Bose, who was so dominant last week.
I wasn't even supposed to be here, but the boss called me and told me you guys were desperately flailing up here.
Yeah.
So I flew right over here from Florida. Express jet. Look out, look at that.
The doctor with such strength.
And the doctor
goes to the big boot home. Arcadia.
Arcadia the champion.
Look at his shirt there.
Oh, Arcadia can't lift him off. He's too big.
John, let's go. It sends Arcadia in. And Arcadia falls.
Arcadia has two-time UWA heavyweight.
He cannot handle this monster, John Bose. It's just not in him. I know for a fact.
285 pounds. He is.
Look how scared he is. Look at that. Look on his face. Oh, there you go.
John Bose is taking all of his
match. I think Arcadia has to.
That's an augmented offense there. Unless he just wants to cheat to win again and keep the title.
There goes Arcadia on the ropes, ducks the line, comes back, oh, a big flying forearm.
That is one advantage Arcadia has. He can jump higher and move much faster.
But if John Bose,
when you got a beast like this as your opponent.
If John Bose gets his hands on Arcadia.
Oh, God.
With the leg.
Stretch muffler coming right away.
Going for that stretch muffler. Can't get it in.
Oh! Oh!
That was pick of Arcadia's night. Ever.
Arcadia with a beautiful insecurity there.
Uh-oh. And Bo sits up.
But the doctor...
Bo just sat right back up.
It's like Beowulf and Grendel.
I have no idea what you just said.
You know, I got the ref.
I know what you're saying.
I got the reference, but
someone here is educated.
I read a news article once where they're...
Big shoot off here.
That's exactly my point.
Did you just make sense?
Dang it! Sick!
Viscous kick.
Get out of here.
Oh, really?
A waste of space.
Get it myself.
Oh, can I have your trials?
Yes.
All right, here we go.
Thank you. All right, take some boots to the midsection.
Katie is in a world of hurt.
I don't think he stands as much of a chance as he came in here. Came off a big win again, off a big win.
Here we go.
Once again.
Really?
I don't know about that, Keaton. Are you here? Chad Jones is going to split. Peace.
Bye, Chad. John Bowes just choking the life out of Arcadia. Here we go. Shooting him off.
Not enough like that.
Katie off the ropes. Uh-oh, go over that big... Oh! Feet of the fourth panel. The big bow backbreaker.
He is done. This is over. This is... Arcadia doesn't stand a chance.
Shut up.
This is not look one, two, three. All right, ring the bell. What's
actually, that would be two.
You got the Brawl for
that would be two.
What?
Yeah, I was surprised, too. I really thought that would take...
Where's my $1,000, by the way?
I don't owe you no money.
Shook, I remember because I washed my hands 8 times after it. Anyway,
to bring me beer.
John Bo's going to town on that knee there of Arcadia.
Definitely.
Working on that knee to soften it up, that stretch muffler that Bo's loving.
There you go.
With a knee. Like, wouldn't you go to town with a woman?
Bo's
maybe some money.
Made Tech tap that stretch muffler last year. Made Vince Valentine tap last week. He's a monster. And there is no escaping once you get put up in the air, held there by Bo's.
No, you're pissing me off. I'm getting out of here. I'll be back later.
Bo's still wrenching on that knee, trying to pull it out of its socket there.
He's getting pretty close to successful. I think Arcadia might want to throw in the towel at this point if he knows what's good for him.
If you know Arcadia at all, you know he's not going to throw in the towel for anyone. Well, Arcadia lands right on his feet and fires back with forearms to the vicious doctor. Big dropkick, Bo's. The dropkick didn't faze him. Down! I thought we had a new champion right there. That dropkick did not even phase this beast.
Look at these little stick legs he's got. He's not going to be able to put enough on him to take a monster like that off his feet. It's like tree trunks and saplings.
Man, it's monster.
He's a behemoth, all right.
Beast.
Remember about hearing about a guy named Leviathan?
Leviathan?
That's what I think when I look at John Bowen. No, Leviathan.
What's
his name? Crowd.
Brad's trying to rally behind Arcadia here.
Come back yet?
No, they're letting John go.
Our hands are starting to hurt! Hurry up!
Oh!
Stop.
Going for that straight jacket, Styles Clash, Coach,
no
that's gotta hurt.
Bo's
blocking it. I don't think Arcadia's gonna be able to get that.
Especially not with that leg.
Inside out.
Jesus
with that big line right there.
Getting hit with a cod.
Can you imagine the United Wrestling Alliance with John Bo's as the heavyweight champion, as John Bo's tears through a punch. What a huge
with lariats like that, I definitely could. This, what better monster to lead? Close call there. I don't know how much he's got left to be able to kick out of even that.
It's not about Arcadia beating Bo's here, I think. It's about Arcadia surviving the onslaught given by this monster.
That's what he's good for. He can retain a title. I'll give him that. He's got an objective, a goal. But I wouldn't say that he's a monster and that Bo's is enough to actually win the championship.
The brute strength of John Bo's may prove too much here. As John the veteran gets a foot up, punch to the top.
Neckbreaker coming.
Oh, he nailed it.
Blockbuster.
Big blockbuster there.
Time is
one.
Danny Baker starting the standing 10 count.
Two.
As Arcadia crawls over to Bo's.
One.
Covers one.
Two.
two, and John Bose gets his shoulder up.
I think Bose is just starting to realize maybe this guy has that belt for a reason.
Absolutely. Archadia, probably one of the most, probably the most accomplished man in the United Wrestling Alliance. He has held heavyweight titles in the USW, the EWF, the SWF, and
right
the
now he's holding
and right
gravity.
Now
he's holding gravity.
Right the hand of God.
Giant leg drop.
Trifecta, baby. And yes, he nailed it.
One, two.
I thought John Bose was going to maybe stay down for that. That leg drop from the top, crushing down on the monster's larynx, still is not
what way can you really keep down a beast like this? I mean, maybe tie him up? Drown him in something?
Again.
But I don't know that all these strikes
ever
even have much effect.
Ever since that
loss to Tech.
Ever since that. Oh! Knee! The knee on the hand of God!
Landing right on the knee. Arcadia in a bad way here.
Picking him up. Close with Arcadia. Look at the size of this man.
That's some junkage.
Turnbuckle right in
the face. Oh, Arcadia fires back! Arcadia sitting on the top rope is nose to nose with Dr. John Bose.
Oh my goodness.
No.
They are going up.
Bose is on the second.
Oh my gosh.
What could he have in the mind?
I think I know.
I think I might know as well.
What is John
serious? This is not a place for someone his size to be.
Bro, what is he doing?
Could he
superflex?
Be
going?
Big suit. Oh god, what a superflex this will be.
Oh my god.
Crap!
Oh! And there
it is! It. New champion!
That was disgusting! One! Two!
You just don't see man like that size to pulling off maneuvers like that. That baffles my mind.
Four!
John Bose covers! One! Two! Arcadia at the foot of the ropes!
The ring awareness there, the veteran Arcadia.
Beautiful ring awareness. Pardon my half Japanese accent.
You left, remember?
Yeah, but I'm back. Frank McGavin left.
Are you back in all brand new? Because if you're worn out, I'm going to throw you out like socks.
Anyway. Absolutely leveling Arcadia.
What is
no.
John Bose is looking at
him. Look at his eye before. He's not thinking of trying to grab
it. Don't do it. This will shine. Do it.
You can do it!
No, he's saying no!
You lost over
that way,
John!
I don't think he needs to put that much fuel behind it. Come
on, John!
He's got him right in the offensive.
John Bose dropped to Arcadia at Armageddon 5 because he missed! Because he went for the 450 splash!
Fuck him!
He's
landing on his feet!
He's going for that! Went for the big boot. Arcadia in the corner.
Still
throwing him down. Arcadia went low there.
Kicks at the inner thigh, man.
Way low.
Swinging boot out. Both men are just exhausted by this point.
Arcadia going up? Could he be going? Going for the hand of God here, possibly.
Yeah, I don't believe in him.
If we say that, Frank McGavin might come back.
Hand of Allah.
Going for the hand of God here.
Wisely getting out of the way.
If you recall, Armageddon 5, John Bose and Arcadia met for the regional title. Arcadia coming up top.
Two.
Arcadia driver off the top
three.
Rope.
That's it.
Three.
Incredibly
Paul and John Bose went
four.
Four.
Five.
Hit five, ladies and gentlemen.
Six.
The third.
Six.
The third standing kick out of this match.
Seven. Eight.
Which way? So it's feet first.
Feet. Back up. Bose nails Arcadia. Arcadia nails Bose.
Right back.
Bose hits up the ropes.
They're giving it everything they have left.
This is just a slugfest now, ladies and gentlemen. Arcadia and Bose. Arcadia has to jump to nail Bose with that forearm. My foot!
Takes him out there with the strike right after the knee.
It might be over. No one gets out of this. No one. Arcadia nails. Arcadia gets
the ropes.
Reversal.
Why is that if we got the Bosey butt crack here? As Arcadia.
Up.
Famous
right back into the
top right back.
Oh no.
That was
you are in so much trouble.
Jabos trying desperately to get Arcadia on the ground.
Oh my god.
Teague needs to be setting in at this point.
He'd be going for it now. He looks like he's setting
ropes.
Arcadia all up in them ropes.
Oh,
what?
Sunset flips. Jabos rolls through.
He couldn't quite muscle that maneuver with that leg.
Staying on that leg.
Trying to get him out of that. He just can't get away from him.
We're going to try to lift him up again to stretch him up.
If he lays down, he's halfway across the ring.
True.
You can reach him anywhere.
Now John's slowing it down to his level.
Jumbo's wrenching Arcadia on the ground here, keeping him base on the mat. Good move by the doctor, not to exhaust himself anymore, but lifting Arcadia up in the air to stretch him up.
Arcadia's in a world of hurt here. He needs to get to that rope.
Arcadia may be tapping out.
Hey, is that Lando Calrissian?
Arcadia may have had enough.
Yeah, okay.
Well, I think he's had plenty at this point. I'm surprised he's still alive, awake,
breathing. He's got him up! This might be it. Arcadia's title might be short.
Wait, he's got the rope!
Come on!
Go with a cross arm. Nope.
I don't think it's gonna work.
Can't lift him with only one leg.
Man with one. Man can't stand, right, he can't fight. That's from Karate Kid, part 3.
All right, way to bring up that one.
Better to, but if you ever seen Star Trek, you know, then you know.
Hey, Arcadia, go over that. It's got to hurt one more time.
Could he get him?
Oh, my God!
That was amazing! Yeah. And he gets it! He retains the title!
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner and still UWA Heavyweight Champion, Arcadia.
What a war!
Every 90 seconds thereafter, another individual enter according to the number in which they drew. This process continues until all 30 men have entered the match. A wrestler is eliminated when he is thrown over the top rope and both feet touch the floor. This process will continue until only one man is left standing, and that individual will be declared the winner and the number one contender for the UWA Undisputed Championship at Armageddon 6. And now, let us find out who drew number one.
It's a conspiracy. Same thing happened to Nixon.
government conspiracy.
And now, the individual who drew number two. Well, ladies and gentlemen, Vince Regal here at ringside alongside Arkham, and we're getting ready to go with the 2005 Brawl for an All match. It appears that Quake and Kris Collins now are going to start this thing. And we may get rid of Kris Kaos. Now, you got to admit, I mean, I'm not going to say that Kris Kaos had a hell of a chance of winning this to begin with, but this certainly didn't help matters.
Not in the least, because I think just about 75% of the UWA roster has a weight advantage over Kris Kaos. And a weight advantage is a big advantage when it comes to battle royals.
Now, as our great, very talented ring announcer pointed out earlier, another guy's going to come in about 90 seconds. We've got about a minute left.
See, and the whole point about any kind of battle royal is it's completely at random. There's no way to prepare for a match like this at all.
No, absolutely not.
Like, what are you going to do? You're going to get 29 tapes and watch each one of them night before the brawl? You're not going to be ready.
Well, folks, we got some surprises here. We got all your favorite UWA superstars. What a match, though. Not to take anything away from this, of Archadia and... Arcadia and Bose just a couple minutes ago.
And definitely not even to be a joke, not even to be funny or anything, but that is a match of the year candidate.
And here we go. Just took the Amazing Green's head off. Oh my God. Green may be done. Green's had a rough night already. You saw him earlier tonight on
in his debut match against John Rome, the right hand man of you.
That's right. My new Padawan, if you will.
Well, so how did that come about?
Well, you know, Rome, he's been impressing me. I went scouting during the offseason. Oh, Green might be gone there. Yeah, anyway, I was scouting during the offseason, and you know what? Rome impressed me, and that's why I decided to make him my new ward here in the UWA.
I'll give you this. You and me really don't agree on many things.
No, absolutely not.
I think his showing against Green today was very impressive.
Oh, you can kick harder than that.
And Quake getting his butt whooped by the cruiserweights here. I don't know what they're...
Well, each person in this ring right now has had a pretty...
What?
Pretty in the world? Competition earlier in the day.
Well, folks, we still have a long way to go. 27 more men will enter this match. Oh, big trip.
Whoa. Big trip?
No, not that trip. The move, the trip, not the guy trip.
Big stumbling suplex variation.
Very impressive. I gotta say, Kris Kaos, he's not doing too bad in here. Considering,
you also gotta keep in mind, like, Kaos and Green don't have the best of relationships.
Oh!
I think they wrestled each other like 35 times last season. 3, 2, 1!
Before Jesus!
Uh-oh!
Oh no!
That business is fixing the pickup! Kris Collins is, wow! Kris Kaos!
You really are a big fan of Kris Collins.
Oh, and Mason Green is gone! Mason Green is gone. I was going to say, Kris Kaos was on the floor, he was not thrown out, he rolled out. Uh-oh.
Oh God.
Oh, big Yakuza kick, and there goes Kris Kaos.
Come on.
Brass is on fire, man.
I'll give you the first one.
I feel for Quake right now.
And this is a fresh Brian Brass, too. Chaos, Green, and Quake, rather, all had matches earlier tonight. And Brass has cleared the ring.
Well, see, now what an advantage for Brass, because, like, how long is it between?
It's 90 seconds. He's got, you know.
He eliminated them within 20.
Yeah.
That means he gets to just hang out for, like, over a minute.
Yes. Well, I'll tell you what. Now, this is going to be,
White Quest, I hope you're number 5. Wherever you are. What's up? Rip his shorts?
What? 10! No!
Bogus!
7!
Come on!
5!
Well, we're gonna find out who's next.
2-1!
What is this?
Did we recruit the other?
What is this? Wait, this is Brian Brass's music!
Now, for those of you...
He's got him up! Southern Justice!
Yeah,
Southern Justice!
That are not aware...
Oh,
Ryan
no.
Ryan Brass hates, loathes Rebel.
What?
Oh, what an ass punch.
Do you realize you just said, oh, what an ass punch?
It is an effective move!
And Rebel is taking it to... To Brian Brass. Uh-oh. Oh, and he was. Brian Brass just eliminated Rebel.
One more chance. I'm coming again.
Yeah.
Brian Brass. Oh. And Rebel just got eliminated twice.
Is that possible?
Well, that.
7, 6, 5.
You still suck.
Three.
I hate you.
Oh yeah.
Oh no.
If I win this battle royal,
title shot
at Armageddon.
Oh, yeah. Come on.
Why would you do that with those boots on? Oh, God. Oh, well, I can tell you.
Jay Blackheart, another surprise entrant in this match.
Yeah, I thought that Jay Blackheart's contract expired halfway through last year.
Yeah, well, everybody wants a shot at the heavyweight title shot. Heavyweight title. Oh! Oh! Big spine buster. Jay Blackheart just taking it to Brian Brass. Jay Blackheart seems to have a change of attitude.
Well, it's a lot more, when your contract runs out and everybody hates you.
Yeah.
You want to come back. You want people to like you.
Oh.
Hey, my bandana.
Oh, that was tremendous. Folks, Jay Blackheart was, what was he, number 6?
Yes.
Number 6, we have 24 to go.
Oh, his turn for for a spine buster.
Now they're Jay Lethal.
Potato!
Potato!
Big shot!
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. You paid your dues!
It's Big Dan Winant, the biggest man in this battle royal.
You said not to be on the patio, and the CD just skips. Get off the patio.
That's you.
Former NBW members Jay Blackheart and Big Dan rejoining their alliances here.
Hey, Blackheart!
Uh-oh. Jay Blackheart said he's got a line, too. Watch this one. And Brian Brass is just being picked apart by the former NBW. Big senton. Harley Race knee drop there.
Cannonball, man!
Yeah! Big splash. This is going to be a long night for Brian Brass, let me tell you.
Cannonball!
So I guess, I mean, Blackheart must have had that much of a change of heart. Teaming up here with a...
Well, what did you team up with Big Dan?
I mean, I have an ally like Big Dan in the back royal. I mean, he has the biggest advantage.
Man, I'll tell you what, Blackheart and Dan are beating on Brass like he's a babyface.
Who won the Brawl for
I'm telling you. Who won the Brawl for all last year? Big Dan. No, excuse me, Cypress did. Big Dan won it the year before that. Cypress won it the year before that.
Like I was saying, Dan has experience in the Brawl for Dolls. He won a Brawl for Dolls.
And he's also 400 pounds.
You're not doing that. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4.
And I don't know if this is really legal.
Are they taking a four spot for one?
That's why they all came in together. And they are dismantling Jay Blackheart, Brian Brass, and Big Dan. This isn't completely fair, Arkham. I think even you got to admit that.
I said that was the first game out. They're taking up one spot. I guess their whole psychology of it is they are one being. I'll say one thing. I am glad that I'm not a part of this problem.
Yeah. Especially right now. The machine. The
machines.
Machines. Look at how many of them are there. You know that one machine gets a little bit smaller than the rest.
Wait, Did they just kill four G-Plazas?
Yeah, basically. Something like that.
Potato!
Overhead throw! And Brass, Jay Blackheart, and Big Dan are just getting dismantled here.
All right, Mr. Regal. You know what we're talking about? Big Dan had the big advantage?
Yeah.
I think the machine has the advantage.
3, 2, 1.
Oh! trying to fight off these machines. I don't. Oh, that didn't work. He tried. It was a. I'll give him credit. I don't like the guy, but it was a hell of an effort.
Cypress.
Uh oh.
The most decorated UWA superstars.
Though. And here we go.
But against the machines.
It's the UWA versus the machines here. We got Brass, Cypress, Big Dan, and Jay Blackheart all on the same page.
In stereo.
Oh. Oh no. We all missed him. And the UWA has just eliminated an army of machines. And now it's right back to every man for themselves.
Well, you have to be somewhat impressed with the unity of Jay Blackheart, Brian Brass, Big Dan, and Cypress.
Well, yeah, I mean, I think they realized it was a desperate times call for desperate measures. And that was going to be rough. I mean, big splash by Jay Blackheart. Oh, no. Dance. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Oh,
no.
Monkeys.
Brian Brass is not having a good day in this match.
Not in the league. No.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3.
He is here, but he's.
I think that JTQ has a huge advantage. Because not only does he scare people,
but he's scared of people.
But he's scared of people.
I never played that. Oh!
He's in a bad punch jar!
See, that's why he's not in the ring, because he is scared of people.
Well, he you know, you can call JT Cruz a lot of things, but right now he's pretty damn smart.
I wouldn't want to get in the ring.
You realize that JT Cruz weighs about as much as one of Big Dan's legs. You have to understand that.
And in the ring right now, you have four of UWA's top tier competitors.
You have three former heavyweight champions in the ring right now, and Shane Blackheart, who really needs no introduction.
But Brian Brass gave him one before.
Yeah, he did.
But it was the wrong one.
JT Cruz biding his time here now.
If I was him, I would stay out until number 30.
Well, you can't really do that. He has to get into the ring at least once by the time the next guy gets in there. He can go in, he can roll right back out, but Brass got him. I guess we're not going to have to worry about this.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Some kind of a one-sided opinion at the moment.
Oh, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on.
No, help me.
I'm willing you in, Rome. I'm willing for you. Dan, thank you. Good, good man.
I don't think he did that before.
Yeah, Big Dan and I are, we're buds. We're tight.
It's alright, you have a future.
Whether you're buds or not.
And
this is for the heavyweight title. There are no alliances.
No, there's not, but you know what? I'm not complete. Rome is, he's picking his spots here. Oh, big BO throw by Big Dan.
Oh, poor JT.
Chop
him back.
Hey, I got him. Oh, Dan! No, Dan! No, Dan! Oh! Dan, no! Dan! Oh!
Make him stop! What do you want me to do? Make him stop!
I have a broken arm!
Ask him nicely, you're a nice guy.
My dad doesn't like me!
3, 2, 1!
Cut the music, yo, who pulled that? Turn the singing off. Help if it was on, all right? I'm not the sound guy, and they better fire one for today, all right? That bunch of music's before.
Not cool. Listen, chillax, hoople heads, I said chillax.
What is he doing?
As some of you may well know, not in the best of moods. I lost to a portly Mexican and a skinny Nipponese fella already. And as some of you are aware, after I win this thing, I don't have the time to celebrate. I gotta take my title shot to Barnes & Noble's and work the jazz geek gimmick.
What is he talking?
So I'm gonna ask for a favor from all of you when you're not kicking out of Cyprus and I'm like, doing that. I am gonna give.
What?
All of you, to the count of 10, to get your filthy, yellow keisters off my property before I slap your heads for fresh.
What is he doing?
One.
Two. What?
Two.
Did he just say everything? Oh. Well, there was so much for that.
I don't think that any idol was on request. No.
What the hell? Get him.
I don't think his request was met with much happiness.
Well, you gotta give him an A for effort.
An A?
C plus, baby. Uh-oh.
Ah, damn it!
Oh, and there goes Eddie Idol!
That is something that I didn't think I was gonna
do! And there goes GT Cruz!
If I'm correct, JT Cruz and Eddie Idol share a
clothesline. I've read that on the internet, however, I don't know if that's ever been confirmed. Well, Jay, what are you doing, Jay?
Everybody has had a piece of the future today.
Wait, no! Come on!
No, I'm trying to help you!
No.
Dan!
No!
Go, Dan!
Dan! 6, 5, 4, 3, 2,
Yeah, Quest going right to Quest, brass!
Quest dance!
Do the dance!
I don't think Quest really appreciated
Come
brass
on! Balls. Come on!
I'm very surprised that Quest doesn't just stay on top of Brian Bird.
Oh, come on, guys! You are friends with him! Make him stop! Make him stop!
There's nothing that I can do!
You're friends with him! Tell him to stop!
Like I said, you and me don't get along, and I'm best friends with Quest, but what happened to Rome? That was just mean.
Come on!
That don't hurt the future.
Oh, what? What's the
word? All the people here that...
Oh, no.
Blackheart is the one trying to help.
Boot scrape! Oh, big knee. I thought he was going for a boot scrape.
It's a safe assumption that Blackheart's going to get a little bit extra payday today. Because he's been doing nothing but trying to help.
Oh, big spear. Big core. Oh, no. 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 Arkham! Oh, no! Damn it, Cypress! I hate him.
Well, you've always had.
Yeah, so. Oh, I hate him.
10, 9, 8, 7.
Count it down, bitches! 4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh!
people that I guarantee you are going to work together. I guarantee you, Big Dan and Kyle.
I'm going to go back to saying that Big Dan Winant has the advantage right now.
Yeah.
Because not only is he almost 400 pounds, but he has Kyle Winant on his side.
Squash him! Get ready!
And...
Oh, God.
Coming up next is number 15. We're halfway there. Oh.
Watch it. Watch it.
That is one thing you don't want to be on the receiving end of, I'll tell you that much.
Yeah, well, you know, I've never had to take it, but you know what? I've come to that conclusion.
Come on! Psych!
Oh!
That was great! So it's
that we have Dan and Jay Blackheart attacked each other yet?
I don't believe so.
I don't think so.
So right now
it's like a three-man team. Because Dan's not gonna attack Kyle. Kyle's not gonna attack Dan, and it seems like Blackheart's on the same page with Dan.
Thus meaning he's not gonna attack Kyle.
Yes, that's what I would assume.
So you gotta feel a little bit of sympathy for Brask.
Well, actually,
Joey Dick for Killer!
You have to feel a little bit of sympathy for Cypress, because Brass and Quest aren't worried about anybody else!
Big time elimination! Brass! Brass is gone!
So
Sha-na-na-na! Goodbye!
Well, I guess it wasn't just all luck,
what?
Huh?
What is Kyle? Oh, there's a whole lot of screaming and a whole lot of banging right there.
That's another thing you don't want to be on the receiving end. Because we did find out earlier today, Kyle weighs 270 pounds.
Yes, and that's why he's now the former Cruiserweight Champion.
Yes, his balls are showing.
God damn it! Oh!
Well, Brass just found out that he was
losing. Oh my God! Oh!
And Chris Maverick is number 15, which means that 50% of the participants are now in this match.
Move!
Come on! What is going on here? Uh-oh. Oh! Jay Blackheart just flung Quest across the ring. What is he doing? Oh! Maverick looks perplexed now.
Oh! You were in a...
Oh! You see, so I told you, Big Dan and Jay Blackheart are clearly working in tandem here.
See, I thought we all had a change of heart from the
Jay Blackheart. Oh, you missed.
Good with that.
The first one.
Oh.
Hey, I like that choking thing.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Joey Hedges, what happened to tag team champions? Taking it to Kyle Winant.
Hedges is stiff.
Hedges looks hungry.
Oh!
You're mean!
Jay Blackheart outsmarted Joey Hedges. Granted, that's not that hard, but I still laugh. Oh! A big Yakuza kick!
Yakuza, in the words of our most hated commentator.
You punk! Go!
Well, out of everybody in here, who's been in here the longest, Arkham?
Big Dan, I believe.
Yeah, I would believe so. Oh yeah, Jay Blackheart, excuse me.
Oh.
shots.
Get out of my way.
Oh, big Russian leg sweep.
Free chops.
Free shot. Oh, no. Oh, it's the heart lock. Oh.
It's Jay Black's heart lock. That move is disgusting.
The heart lock?
The heart lock. You're like,
what the hell is this? Disaster! He's in this.
Hold on, how did
that happen? Why didn't anybody tell me about this?
From what I remember, don't you despise?
Yes, which is what I want to know, why nobody told me about this. This has to be...
You're gonna have to have
this
a
has
meeting.
To be my dude.
You're gonna have to have a meeting with upper management.
Yeah. Oh, they're all trying to get rid of Kyle.
Aren't you upper management? Can't nobody get signed without your permission?
They're not supposed to.
Somebody's going behind your back, and I have a feeling it's Paul.
Listen, I'm just gonna try to enjoy the rest of this match. Don't get me stirred up. Come on, Maverick, toss him. Come on, Maverick. I'll give you $50 to toss him. He's doing it. He's doing it. He's doing it. Come on. He got him. He got him. $50 from Maverick. Keep this written down somewhere.
Yeah!
Oh!
What?
Flying
what was that? What was that move?
Whoa, whoa! Brass! What is Brass doing? I you know what? I don't really like my quest, but that's not exactly fair.
Nobody ever said that the Brawford All was a fair match. I mean,
I don't, what in the world?
If the Brawford All was fair, do you think that Jay Blackheart, Big Dan, and Kyle Winant would have a race?
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Why not? There's no disqualifications.
Come on, isn't he the world champion? We gotta get him out.
Joey Hedge is now trying to get on the outlaw, but Maverick cut him off. Blackheart fell through the ropes, not over the top rope. If he goes out, which he did, he's not eliminated. Jay Blackheart is still in this match.
Come on, Jay. Jay, remember when you wanted to come out in one of those?
No, he said Jay Blackheart's still in this thing. Yeah, we know, Jay. Don't worry.
Way to keep an eye out, boss.
Oh, Kris Maverick.
Almost gone.
Oh, he held on.
Surprised Jay didn't help.
Yeah!
No! Yeah! No! Yeah!
No! Yeah! No! Kyle destroying Hedges' trachea. Yeah.
No more, bitch!
No springboard, you can go up.
I'm in there.
Oh! Big European by the outlaw.
I can surround it in hard plastic. You hit it, it's not going to do anything.
10, 9, 8. There's more people. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Jay Blackheart just rolled out of the ring here. He's taking a breather on the ground right in front of us. Once again, he did not go over the top rope. And once again, G-Paz is in this match, although you can't tell by his performance. That was...
What just happened?
Outlaw just suplexed G-Paz into Kyle. And...
Ouch!
Oh! Outlaw! Outlaw! He might be. Oh! Oh God!
Oh God! Oh
God!
That has to be the hands down heaviest German suplex.
Ouch.
Oh! Jay Blackheart just drilled the outlaw like he was nothing. Oh, and now choking. I'll tell you what. There's not really a fresh guy in this match right now, Arkham. Right, Arkham? Just leave me hanging. Yeah, okay.
No! No!
So right now in this ring,
I still gotta go with Big Dan.
He's stood the test of time so far.
Yeah, he has.
Because now he's been in really like the second longest in the ring.
And as long as he can keep tiring out everybody as they come in, they're not going to have the energy
but
to toss him.
He's still remaining on the offensive on most of the people that he squares off.
9, 8, 7, 6.
Well, another contestant's coming up next.
7.
And you know Ace Jack, wants to win this thing.
Oh boy!
Oh! Oh!
Because arm drags have places in
them. Oh! Ace Jack and G-Paz, oh!
I think Pinkstick has a pretty good chance of winning.
I mean, he's
we got 9 guys in the ring right now.
Oh no!
Big back suplex.
What number was
H-Jack was 20.
H-Jack was number 20. So we're 2/3 of the way home now.
I got 3 condoms!
Oh, big forearm shot. Uh-oh. Oh, here we go. Oh. Former four-time UWA champion to be
Did you not see that one coming, Matt Mitchell?
Oh!
Yeah!
Don't
fucking do that.
Well, there's now an even 10 in this match.
Ouch! I still can't believe how big fans remaining on the offense.
Oh, Kyle's going up.
Wait, this is...
Come on.
Oh!
Give me
Kyle.
A Kyle Flash. Oh, we got Ishak and an Outlaw going at it.
My God!
What a fucking asshole
that is! That's more than a box, but it's coming from big time. That's everybody.
Hey, Shaq, fire it up on anything that'll move.
It's a rack of brick breakers.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Real deal by Nelson. Another Filipino UWA heavyweight champion in this match. Matt Mitchell just eliminated G-Paws there.
Oh, we only got like something real in the ring.
Oh, and Matt Mitchell almost just eliminated the Outlaw. You realize with the exception of Archadia, every single former UWA champion is in this ring right now.
Are you serious?
Every single one with the exception of Archadia.
That is amazing.
Who is the reigning champion?
Not to take anything away from anybody who didn't hold the heavyweight title.
Oh no, well that, they may be just as hungry if not even hungrier.
There's not many people in that ring that haven't held some sort of title.
No, in fact, I don't know if there's anybody that hasn't had a title, with the exception of Chris Maverick and Jay Blackheart. Oh!
Reverse choke slam there by Christopher Maverick.
Oh! Outlaw and Ishak! Like, they are really close to getting eliminated here. Oh!
Christ, taking him, he's gonna break his jaw.
Yeah!
Maverick escaping into the foliage.
You all can't be in one corner.
He brings me to
the floor. Cypress boot!
Go! Go!
Go! Go! Go! Go!
Go!
Go! Go!
The wear and tear is starting to set in. Because somebody's been like, Big Dan's been in the second longest, and he's still like, he's still going.
People have to go out.
Jay Blackheart trying to make a valiant effort, but I don't think Jay Blackheart's going to be able to hold the dead weight.
Back into the ring.
Take your hat off.
I choose.
There it is. Oh, that just is stiff.
Hey, whose bump is that?
Neckles.
About time, that
who's. Yeah, sorry.
Hey,
how you been?
Oh God!
Oh, it's very by Big Dan.
What is the outlaw doing?
Count it! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Hold on, that was a 10 count. Does that mean somebody has to leave?
No!
Hey,
get him back for me! Nobody's touching my idiot but me!
Jack, I'm touching his back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
That's tremendous.
Whip in corner.
I don't even know what
lung blower sandwich, baby.
Well, one was a lung blower, the other one was a blower sandwich.
So 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh, big time backbreaker by the outlaw.
For once, there was no reason.
Oh, he's almost gone.
Well, there are only four more participants to enter this match. And there goes Mike Nelson, courtesy of Matt Mitchell.
I got this.
Oh, wow.
Oh! Oh, damage, held on.
Come on, Scotty! Come on, Scotty! Don't you ever try to mess with me! I'm the real champ! Come on!
Hit him!
Hit him!
He wants to
Well, Arkham has stepped out, and I am joined here by Wes Matthews.
Hey!
Wes, long time no see.
Yeah, it's been a while, about 6.5 months, I guess.
Yeah.
What we got going on here? I was in the shower.
Wow. Oh, it is the brawl for
Oh, wait, that's today.
Big Sambo!
That's what I'm talking
about. You missed it. Rebel was here.
What?
Rebel was here.
God, why do I always miss the good stuff? Another Sambo! Yell, yell, yell!
I don't think he's gonna Sambo, Big Dan.
Oh, God! Why does he hurt people like that? It's not very nice of him.
That was pretty good.
Well, you know, this is wrestling.
That is correct. It's been 6 months. You can't ease up a little bit.
Oh, big Russian leg sweep.
I hate that move. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Well, that is not the right music. That was Eddie Idol. Well, folks, we have a little bit of technical difficulties here. Somebody else should be coming in right now. And Fire Liger came in just as Joey Hedges was leaving. And Fire Liger was 27. Oh, big chop by Scotty Deletto. Another big chop. Oh, Outlaw firing up on Sky. Of course, there is no love lost. Uh-oh. Scotty trying to eliminate. Big Dan, I don't think he's going anywhere anytime soon.
He's been in there for a while. That's impressive. Fire Liger's wiener showing.
Oh, big chop on J Spider.
That was a sweet. Jay Blackheart, impressive, still in there after how many months off. You got Sean Dan, McNelis, UWA Regional Champion, Cypress and Mitchell, both former heavyweight champions.
Outlaw, former heavyweight champion.
Wanted, Fire Liger, Tag Team Champion.
See, Damage Regional Champion?
Yes, I did. Big Dan, former heavyweight champion. Wow, there's a lot of bait. Yeah,
9, 8, 7,
oh, Diamond Cutter!
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Jack makes his way in here at the 28th entrance.
That means there's only two left.
That is correct. You are a man.
Yes, I am. Uh-oh.
Oh my God, what is he doing? What are they? Oh my God.
What in the world is going on?
Oh!
Oh! Oh. And Tech is gone!
Oh well.
And J-Spider! J-Spider's feet have not touched yet. A-Shack trying to pull his friend in.
Tech actually never made it into the ring. He just climbed up to the top. He's not eliminated.
God, that's...
He was up at the top of the rope.
Yeah, that's true. We're getting the call from referee Danny Baker. Tech's feet never touched inside the ring, therefore technically they couldn't have touched outside of the ring. Oh, and there goes J Spider.
J Spider's out.
He's out now, that's for sure.
It's getting a little windy here at the UWA arena. The only Regal I like, Vince.
Yeah, I heard you the first time, Wes.
I'm just messing with you. No.
Yeah,
Oh, God!
fucking German suplex.
His foot got caught underneath the bottom rope.
Well, Paul Regal was 29. There's only one left. Oh.
There's only one more person left. Do we know who? I don't even know who it is. I've been missing for so long. I don't even know who's in this thing.
They told me I'm on your team, so I'm not gonna attack you.
Wow.
Well,
this is actually the opposite.
I know who's left, but I'm not going to ruin the surprise.
All right, hold on, though.
Then.
Careful. Oh, I thought he was on our team.
No, he's not.
He was lying.
Jay Blackheart appears to be a little bit out of the loop.
Yeah, he's been in there for a while, though. I guess his mind is... He's got no breath.
German!
We got one more entrance.
Come on, buddy.
This is it. It's the last person.
Four,
three, number 30, 2005, Brawl for All.
Oh, Firelighter's gone. Gets eliminated.
Oh, Blackheart gets eliminated by a girl. Right. Go back to the kitchen. You are a woman. So that's it.
Get your vengeance.
Everyone left here is the only people that's here. I have an awful commentator.
Yeah, well, I'll give you that.
Uh-oh. Is this the H-Jack killer? The H-A-K.
Damage with the hell
of
it.
And... Oh, boo!
Oh,
he
blocked it. Oh, blocked it.
Taste the rule of fucking medicine!
Whoa, watch your language! Hey, oh!
DJ tried
to stop
him. Oh, big reverse DDT there.
H-Jack still set up. Oh, here it comes. The AJK, stiffest move in the business. Oh!
And here we go. We are down to 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11. Oh. Whoa, what is... Oh! And Tara Valifax just, you know, may have knocked out the Outlaw, but he actually had a favor. Huh? It damages,
No! Don't hurt Wendy!
I'm not a person!
It's all yours!
No place!
What?
She didn't touch the ground!
Wait!
No place for a woman!
She didn't touch the ground!
Oh, and there goes damage! They're starting to drop like flies now! Oh, and there goes Paul Regal. Another one bites the dust. There's eight left in there now. They're starting to drop like flies.
We're down to the nitty gritty, as
that's
Jesse
right.
The Body Ventura would say. I don't know if he would say that, but I just wanted to say that. Oh, nice little counter there by the Outlaw. Oh my
god. Oh boy.
Oh my god! Why are you so mean to that little man?
Because he didn't give me gas.
Hey, you don't have to leave. What are you doing?
I don't want to be a clown.
The Outlaw taking a nice...
Pile driver!
Uh-oh.
Oh my god, Big Dan.
Hey.
Oh, god! How many we left? We got left in there, Vince?
4, 6, 8.
8 guys left in this. Oh!
Oh! Oh, Outlaw's almost gone. Almost gone.
Was Maverick ever eliminated?
What?
Maverick?
No, I don't think so. Where'd he go?
I don't know. I know when Vincent Valentine came in, he jetted out of there, but I didn't see if he got eliminated or not. So we might even have 9. 8, 9? Who cares?
Uh-oh.
What the?
Come on!
Oh!
Tech has been eliminated.
Tech is gone.
And he lays in the grass. Now this is the point in time where everybody's so tired they don't even know what to do. They're just chilling.
Yeah.
Don't even. Oh, that was blocked. Oh.
Oh!
That was pretty nice.
Oh, Vincent Valentine.
He's going nuts.
Another diamond cutter. Nail in the coffin.
What is he doing?
I don't know if this is the best strategy in the world.
Neo Valentine is going nuts. Heat killer.
Outlaw. Oh, he got.
Hey, I knew it. Maverick's back.
Oh.
Yes. Maverick!
Oh!
God!
John Walter!
Maverick's back, I knew it! Now Maverick's back as well as in there still.
Yeah!
Big Dan looks like a baggy dog.
Well, they have a very complex relationship, I will say that for them.
What's the bleed?
In the background.
Oh. I don't need it.
In the background of that.
Oh, shit.
Oh, Big Dan rolling around like a dog.
Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! By Ace Jack.
Oh! Big double arm DDT now.
Wondering how Big Dan is still standing. He's got half of his shirt ripped off already. We're having the logo.
Uh-oh! Ace Jack going for second double arm DDT.
Wonder what's gonna happen now. We got everyone down. I lied.
Sayonara.
Oh god, here he goes again. What is he doing?
Yeah!
Oh!
I guess that gets you nowhere.
Yeah, it didn't fare all that
shades
well.
Shades of Roddy Piper. Speaking of tongues. I believe it's Gaelic.
Whoa, that love!
Old school! Yeah!
Oh!
Oh my god. Could this be a fatty salt? Oh no, it's the elbow. I'm believing. Here comes something.
Oh! A big senton bomb variation.
In your face.
Uh-oh.
I wonder if that was a message from the
Dave. Oh! Fist drop!
Oh.
And Mitchell taking offense. Oh, there
Mitchell
goes Mitchell.
Eliminated.
Courtesy of Cypress.
Everyone in this ring has been a former heavyweight champion except for Scotty Deletto.
That's right.
Who's your pick right now, Vince? You call it right now. Pick
I'm
one.
Going with Big Dan. He's been my pick since he came in. And I am still my pick now.
I'm going with the underdog of the group. I'm going with Scotty
Deletto.
Scotty the Body Deletto is winning this battle royal run. I think Dan's been in there way too long. Oh! Lightning strikes
twice.
Ace Jack back to his feet, picking up Scotty the Body. You better not throw out my pick or I'll be mad.
Oh, big power bomb.
Scotty the body.
Oh no!
Oh my god. We can't get him.
Went for a gorilla press, Ishak slid down the back.
Outlaw's trying to fight out of it.
And my tape's done. No!
Now he's going for it again.
Oh boy, he's got him up there.
Oh!
Ishak got eliminated.
We're down to the final four. Big Dan Winant, Cypress, the Outlaw, Dave Winant, and Scotty Diletto. Yes, that is true.
Oh!
Now the brothers are teaming up. Oh my god.
Oh!
Here comes Big Dan, what's he got in store? Oh my god. I don't know if that was a butt kick or...
That was straight up.
That was a cheese guy.
His logo ripped.
Yeah, I saw that. I saw that the Big Dan's logo is ripped in half.
Up, Canuck kick!
Shades of Spotswood, 1999.
SWF!
And he's choking him now. Cypher's still down. Big Dan making sure he's okay. You got these four left. They've been through hell. Scotty Diletto is the freshest of them all. He's only been in for, I don't know how long, but it's only been a couple of minutes.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. What's Scotty got in store?
Oh, big torpedo-like move there.
Scotty seems to be on top if you just capitalize and get rid of someone right now.
Yeah.
But instead he's goofing around. He needs to pick someone up right now and throw him out.
Ball like Dan!
That's the ball like Dan.
Uh-oh. And I think Outlaw took some offense to that.
Come on, Scotty! Scotty bomb!
Oh, Scotty bomb!
Version 5!
Oh, big spear!
Cypress, everybody's just laying it all on the line right now.
Well, the last man left after three of these four hit the floor. Oh!
You want to see that sun big boy?
Oh my god. I have a feeling that this is going to hurt Cypress just a little bit.
Slam him for the elbow.
Yeah, get
slam him, man.
And the sun comes out here at the UWA Arena.
Yay!
She's dripping in the water.
Well, 26 men have gone by the wayside here.
Now the brothers teaming together. And
slam him again.
No, he's not in the wrong line!
Oh my god. What do they got in store for the Cypress?
Oh no.
Is he still, what's he doing? It looks like he's gonna stand on his shoulders. Oh, there he goes.
Oh my god.
Oh,
with that flying elbow.
In the words of Vince Regal, I don't think he got all that one that he wanted from it. The bookend.
Yeah, well, as long as I'm on the screen, it's
dying. Where's the Johnny Malibu music? Tired head of the swing right now.
Big palm strike.
Oh, another
big palm strike.
Oh, what a chop. On the other side of the ring, the Outlaw and Cypress in the top rope. Oh!
Oh, Outlaw almost went out there. Up, oh, Scotty in the ropes. Here comes Dan. Up. All four of these men are extremely tired. They have been in here for a very long time.
Uh-oh. 1 foot, it looks like.
Oh! Another fist drop, and he eliminated Scotty with it.
Eliminated Scotty with a fist drop. Oh, and a spear. Both Winant brothers have given spears to Cypress, and he spits. Putting his hair back.
Let's hear it for Big Dan!
That was a sick, sick.
Now Outlaw sending Cypress off. Oh! Like big leg lariat.
Inside leg lariat. A change. Oh my god. Big Dan just says he's going up top. He's going for the hand of God.
Hand of God.
Oh, no, no, he's not. Oh my god.
No.
That's a little far away. Oh!
Oh!
Oh my god! The Outlaw just turned on his brother!
He double Crayola is every man for himself!
This is true.
But I don't believe that. Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Every Wyatt for himself.
Oh! Oh, he hit the sure shot. If Cypress can pick him up and throw him out, he's got this. But I really, really don't want to see that. It's down to Cypress and the Outlaw, both men down now.
Gore!
Cypress went for the gore.
Oh!
Oh! Yeah, while using his brother as a balance.
Oh my god. Yeah, Big Dan is...
Now why would he suplex him back into
it? Yeah, I don't know about that strategy.
That's just plain stupidity.
Shut up!
Get a random
don't you question him. He knows what he's doing. He is a champion.
That's in a barbecue. I think Wayne next door is faking a barbecue.
Sounds like a go-kart.
I want barbecue. No!
Cypress firing up on him.
It smells like a
go-kart. Back elbow by the Outlaw.
Fatty saw!
Why would the Outlaw go to the top rope? He's an experienced member of the UWA roster. Why would he ever, in a battle royal situation,
yeah, this is not good strategy.
Not at all. If I was Danny Baker, I'd just throw him out.
Oh! He overshot that nice one.
Slow motion music video shot.
Music video! Stop it!
Ouch, ouch, ouch.
And Danny Baker is in the ring to check on both men.
Crowd getting behind Cypress here, I think.
I hope.
Both men down. No standing 10 count, meaning that it is Battle Royal rules.
Yeah, and the only way to be gone is to...
This you might need to count.
Stand still here. A little stalemate.
Let's go, Cypress!
Oh! Knee to the shoulder.
Virgin death!
Oh my god.
Oh!
Virgin death!
One of these two men is going to Armageddon next month to face Archadia.
Yeah, one of these men will face Archadia at Armageddon, the main event.
Who's Archadia?
I don't know, some guy.
Where is he?
What you looking? Uh-oh.
He's got the sludgy sludge. This is not fair. Danny Baker, do something!
Why is he in a ring? Put the Royal Rumble.
Danny Baker, I guess, isn't even doing anything.
Well, there's no disqualification.
Yeah,
oh,
blow, he drops it. This is Cypress's chance.
Oh,
he's over. Ah. Oh. Wait, why is Cypress celebrating?
I don't
celebrate till the bushes.
Oh. He hit him with that sledgehammer.
Right in the gullet?
Yeah.
Whoa!
Throw that at me one more time. We're going to be fighting their hair.
The gullet is the crew. That is pretty long.
Listen, I will call the gullet whatever I want to call the gullet.
You can't do that.
Oh, low blow. Cypress, low blowing.
Yeah,
Jay. He's kicking him.
Oh! Outlaw's over the ropes.
On the ropes again. Close to the edge of the edge. Fighting back and forth. What are they going up for?
I don't know about this one.
I don't know either.
Looks like he's going for, I don't know if Cypress got the upper hand or not. Going back up.
What are you talking?
No way.
Looks like he's superplexing him.
No way.
No. Oh, big time superplex back into the ring.
Cypress!
Cypress! Cypress! Cypress! Cypress! Cypress! Cypress! Cypress!
Outlaw caught him.
Could he be going for a K5 jerky?
He might be.
Let's hear him call it.
Oh,
they're both on the edge here. This is special.
Outlaw is tangled in those ropes.
In the ropes.
He threw Cypress out. Cypress. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the 2005 Brawl for It All match, the Outlaw, Dave Winant. And the Outlaw, Dave Winant, he lucked out there. And he is going to Armageddon to face Archadia.
That bastard John Evans locked me in a cage, damn it. What's going on? God won, you see that?
Shut up. It was fine when you weren't here.
The Outlaw Dave Winant is going to Armageddon. That's the number one contender.
Six. Where are you, Arcadia?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, for Wes Matthews, for Arkham, I'm Vince Regal saying good night.
The Outlaw
and we
Dave
will
Winant.
See you next week at Meltdown.